Hi there, Sandra here, and welcome back to my channel and to another video. For today's video, continuing from last week's video about the new Arteza supplies I recently received, I'm going to use the Arteza Expert 120 colored pencils and the Arteza Expert Mould-made 100% cotton 300 GSM watercolor paper. In the previous video, I reviewed the Arteza watercolor pencils and I also reviewed the watercolor paper pad that I'm going to use today again, but in today's video, I'm going to make a painting by using the regular colored pencils with Arteza gouache, and I'm also going to talk about the differences between the Arteza papers I've tried so far and which paper is more suitable to use with colored pencils. Arteza offers different types of papers with a premium and expert line, so it can be a bit confusing to know what paper to choose that suits your painting style. If you haven't watched last week's video already, I will leave the link to the video on top right and in the description, which I recommend to check it out before or after this video, as this video is connected to the previous one. So regarding the Arteza Expert colored pencils, I actually already reviewed these pencils in a previous video, which I will leave the link to this video as well on top right and in the description, but I had the 72 color set. While this time Arteza was so kind to send me the set of 120 colored pencils. And since my first review video, I've been enjoying using these pencils for sketches and drawings. They are good quality, they are pigmented and enjoyable to use. The colors blend quite well together. These pencils are quite soft, which I like. However, I wanted to mention that since Arteza pencils are quite soft, they tend to be consumed quite fast. And for now from Arteza you can only buy the full set, but I hope in the future they will sell their products on open stock, so you can replace the colors that you run out without buying the entire set again. Although I'm still not sure if I can use them for selling original works due to the light fastness, which by the way, we can now see the light fastness information of these pencils inside the metal tin behind the lid. Moreover, we can find other informations about these pencils, such as color swatches and color name. And as always, whenever I receive new supplies, I swatched all these colors to see and to show you how they look like. And compared to the 72 set, I was curious to see what additional colors we get in the bigger set and to see if it's worth to invest in the bigger set. So on the color chart I prepared that you are seeing right now, the color name with the red dots are the additional 48 colors from the 72 set, which includes 5 metallic colors as well. By the way, I made 2 color charts, so before making both color charts, I checked the color pencils between the 72 and 120 colored pencils to see if you get the same colors, which they are, aside from 2 colored pencils, which are the same color, but they just changed the name. So on the separate color chart, I only swatched the additional colors to get a better idea of what new colors we get, which there are more red and gray and some blue, plus the 5 metallic colors. Although I think we can see better what additional colors we get in the full color chart comparing to the colors already in the 72 set. So by seeing the new colors added, I do think the 72 color set is already a good set with a great selection of colors, but there are definitely some new and interesting colors in the 120 set, to name some of them, such as ginger, rose sienna, raw amber, roost orange, earth red, violet, sapphire blue, midnight blue, deep teal, spearmint green, hazelnut brown, and almost all the added gray. Although I personally would have preferred more green and less red and gray, but I like that there are more bronze colors. But this is just my personal opinion and my personal preference based on the types of paintings I make. So when it comes to colored pencils, maybe it's only me, but the more color variation you have, the better it is to suit any color palette for any types of paintings you are going to make. While with watercolor pencils, I think you can easily have a smaller selection of colors, as you can blend different colors together to create new colors if you use them wet, while with regular pencil, you can only use them dry. In my opinion, if you can afford to buy the 120 set, it would be a good investment as you really get a wide variety of different colors. Although in my opinion, the 72 set is already good enough, but I will definitely enjoy using some of the additional colors as they are quite unique that can come in handy depending on the painting I'm making. And Arteza also offers the set of 48 color pencils, but at the end, it all depends on your budget and your use of color pencils. There are higher and professional artist quality color pencils, but I find Arteza pencils to be higher quality than student grade, so they are a good option if you enjoy using colored pencils, because these pencils are good quality for an affordable price. For me at least, and for the use I use colored pencils, what matters to me is that they must be pigmented and that they lay down and blend nicely, which I find Arteza pencils to be so, and I enjoy using them. In my first review video of the Arteza colored pencils, I had some problems with the tip breaking and falling off from the pencils, but I wasn't sure if it was because of the pencils or because of my old sharpeners. Then some people in the comments in that video recommended me to buy the T-Gal sharpener, which I bought when I went to Japan last year. I believe it was my old sharpener's fault, because since I started using the T-Gal sharpener, I noticed less breaking. And I love using it because I can choose how long I want the tip to be. And I noticed that with Arteza pencils in particular, if the tip isn't too long, it doesn't break too easily. And regarding this paper pad, in today's video, I wanted to give you further details about papers that are suitable to use with color pencils, because I can't emphasize enough how it's important to have the right paper for the right medium, as mentioned and showed some example in last week's video. And I also wanted to give you a comparison between the Arteza papers I tried so far, since Arteza offered different types of paper and they have a premium and expert line. It can be confusing to know what paper to choose, or at least it was a bit confusing for me. And maybe some of you watching this video would like to purchase Arteza paper but is wondering what kind of paper to get. So I hope this part of the video will help you decide what paper to buy. And not only from Arteza paper selections, but this also applies for other brands. Other brands of papers like Hennemühle also has so many different types of paper to choose from, and you can't know if you're going to like them until you try them, so it's not only about Arteza. However, I only will be able to tell you the differences and my experience among the paper I have from Arteza. So far, I tried the premium mixed media paper, the expert watercolor paper, and the paper I'm going to use today for today's painting, which is the expert mould-made 100% cotton watercolor paper. I also have the acrylic paper pad from Arteza, but this paper is suitable for acrylic paint, so not really for colored pencils. Well, first of all, choosing the right paper for the right medium is really important to really get the most benefit from both the paper and the painting technique. In my opinion, hot press papers, so with a smooth surface, are the best papers for colored pencils, as you will be able to draw defined lines and defined details. It doesn't have to be a heavyweight paper like a watercolor paper. In my case for this painting, I'm using a 300 GSM watercolor paper, but this is because I'm also using gouache. So for water-based techniques, I do recommend at least a 250 GSM paper because they have a better paint and water absorbency and the paper won't buckle much. I tried Arteza colored pencils on different papers in my first review video, and it really depends on the paper itself, but the colors and pigment don't result vibrant on old papers and might not lay down nicely as well. So in this case, I can only recommend to try your colored pencils on different papers you have to see which paper works the best with colored pencils. There are many different kinds of papers from different brands, and there is much more to say. I think I made some video covering this topic on my channel, but I have to check it out. But if so, I will leave the link to those videos in the description. And then about the differences among the Arteza papers I tried so far. Among the expert line of the two watercolor papers I have, the Mould-made is more sturdy and has a better paint and water absorbance and has a better quality overall, while the other one is still good quality, but the absorbance is not as good as a 100% cotton paper. But it's cheaper and more affordable compared to the Mould-made. By trying the Arteza Mould-made with gouache today, it is a great quality paper which I enjoyed using, but I personally prefer using the other expert watercolor paper for gouache as I'm able to paint better defined details, while the Mould-made has a more rough texture, which it's okay for details, but I find this paper works the best with watercolor washes and for overlaying different layers of watercolor washes on top of each other. So depending on the painting I'm going to make, I will keep in mind these features. And about the premium mixed media paper I have, the quality isn't bad at all and it works with different mediums, but because it's only 180 GSM, so it's a pretty lightweight paper and it buckles pretty easily when applying water, I'm going to use this paper just for practice painting and color testing. I assume the premium paper might be lower in quality compared to the expert paper, but I can't say for sure because I haven't tried other premium papers, but it looks like the premium line is a bit cheaper, so I think the premium line is very suitable for students who need a lot of papers for practice, while I would recommend the expert line for more professional artists. So I enjoyed using this paper with both gouache and color pencils, and especially with watercolor pencils. To me, this paper really has such high quality, like other professional quality paper I have. But because this pad comes only with 14 sheets, I'm going to use this paper very carefully for special paintings. And although my other Arteza expert watercolor paper is not the best for colored pencils, it's still a good quality paper that I enjoy using, especially with gouache. So I was very curious to try this paper to see the differences. And I want to take a moment to really thank Arteza for continuing our collaboration and send me all the supplies I've received so far for the past year. Most of the time I was able to choose the supplies I wanted to try, which I don't take it for granted, and they always accommodated my desires, which is so cool from them. If I'm going to try and review a product and art supply, it has to be something that I'm already a bit familiar with it, so I'm able to give you better judgment of what I think about the quality, and in case I'm trying something new, I'm always honest with my opinion and review because I wouldn't recommend you a product if I don't think it's good. And I also always try to take in consideration that everyone comes from a different background and have a different budget and have different preferences and needs when I make my review videos. So I try to provide a general information and then it's always up to you to decide if to buy these products or not. And I truly mean when I say that Arteza offers good quality products for its affordable price, which, as you may know if you aren't new to my channel, I really enjoy using Arteza gouache the most. And I also want to thank you for watching my videos and for your support if you used my affiliate links and my coupon code, because I don't think I would have been able to make so many videos to show you different Arteza art supplies without you and your support. So I couldn't be more grateful for your support. But yeah, back to the video. This time and for this drawing, I wanted to use gouache and colored pencils together to achieve a similar style to my previous rooster drawing and using two different mediums in one drawing. Some people might say that you should only use one medium for your paintings, but I definitely don't think so. I believe it doesn't matter what supplies or medium you use for your artworks as long as you achieve the result you are looking for. And it's amazing how you can achieve different styles and different outcomes when using different mediums. Moreover, you might discover a new style that you like to use in the future, and you might find many advantages by mixing different mediums together. For example, for this painting, I both laid down the colored pencils first and then went over with gouache in the opposite way, which you might be wondering, what is the point of overlaying gouache on top of colored pencils, as gouache is quite covering and it would cover the pencils? Well, first of all, I laid down thin and quite transparent gouache washes, so it's not too covering. The graininess of the pencils still shows through the gouache paint, which makes a very interesting effect. And I wouldn't be able to make this kind of texture by only using gouache. And since colored pencils are wax based and they don't get reactivated with water, I was able to lay down gouache on top of the pencils lines without smudging the lines and without lifting up the color from the pencil underneath. Although my favorite way to use gouache and color pencils together is to lay down thin gouache washes first and then go on top with colored pencils to add details. Even though drawing details with pencils is never as precise and thin as when I paint details with gouache, it still gives an interesting effect to my painting. I don't know why, but I always enjoyed using colored pencils when drawing animals. Maybe because it's simpler to create the fur texture with colored pencils than gouache. This time that I could use gouache, I was able to make some adjustments and change few details on the bird, and especially add some highlights, which I wouldn't have been able to do so with only colored pencils. While for the background, it was definitely easier and much more practical using thin gouache for coloring the background instead of using watercolor pencils like I did on the rooster drawing in last week's video to achieve a similar style. And the colors of this bird reminded me of autumn, so I had to draw an autumn composition, and I chose elements like the grapes and alkekenji plant. I'm not sure how to pronounce it, but I think altogether they match well with each other. The drawings I made today and last week's video are a bit different than my usual gouache style, but I hope you still liked them and I hope you enjoyed watching this video. So yeah, I think that's it. As always, in the description of this video, you will find the links to all the supplies shoved in today's video, as well as the links to Arteza website and Arteza YouTube channel, which you should definitely check it out. I also have a coupon code for you to get 10% off for a limited time if you purchase anything from Arteza website, and you will find my personal coupon code in the description as well. And yeah, that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!